Hello students, today we will continue with microorganisms and us part 2. In today we will discuss about commercial uses of microorganisms and nitrogen fixation. Commercial uses of microorganism means use in the various field of application in different commercial purposes like medicines, food sanitaries, breweries or beverages industries, several more. And another one is the nitrogen fixation. Nitrogen fixation means it is a natural process to absorb nitrogen, free nitrogen from atmosphere by the plants. So let us begin. So commercial uses of microorganisms. So commercial uses, it under this commercial use, it is with there are various fields, okay, numerous fields under which it comes. So basically there are medical field, it is basically used, microorganism basically used to produce antibiotics and vaccines. What are antibiotics? So antibiotics are extracted from microorganisms. These medicines kills or stop the growth of any disease causing microbes. So antibiotics helps to kill or stop the growth of many disease causing microbes. Examples you can see here: streptomycin, tetracycline, erythromycin. These are the different different antibiotics used in various diseases and produced from fungi and bacteria. And basically antibiotics are taken with during cold and flu. Basically it is taken with the decold or anti-nasal or the tablets, so it acts as a booster. There is another fungus called Penicillium. Okay, this helps to develop penicillin, which is widely used to treat bacterial infections. Another is the vaccine, what are vaccines? Okay, so vaccines are made from dead or weakened disease causing microbes. So vaccine basically during childhood days or during the newly born infants, okay, the health system, okay, it starts vaccinating infants, newly born childs, because they want to keep the infants or the newly born babies away from these various life taking diseases. So vaccines are nothing but they are mostly dead or weakened virus. They are the virus chemically treated and made dead or weakened, okay, with the help of chemicals. So they are nothing but they are weakened disease causing microbes. So what happens in the body system is when we put the dead or the weakened disease microbes, what happens, our body forms an antibody, our body immune system forms an antibody. So they will make us antibody protection system in our immune system. So whenever in future, okay, this deadly virus attacks us, then what happens, they will remember that, okay, they will remember that the vaccinate, it has been already vaccinated in the immune system. So they will remember, oh, this virus is vaccinated in our body, it is already in our body, so let us protect it from it. So they will protect from that particle. So for each and every disease, okay, we are vaccinated. So in case of getting caught by those diseases, what happens, the immune system remember the vaccinations, okay, the different vaccinations, so they will start forming the protection guard in our immune system protecting from those foreign bodies or those disease causing microbes. Examples of polio vaccine, BCG vaccine, etc. So Edward Jenner was the first to discover the vaccination. This is a very important adventure in 1796. Next is the fermentation. Fermentation is a process in which the bacteria respire without oxygen and produce alcohol. So fermentation is a process, so without oxygen, so the bacteria, microorganisms or the bacteria basically respire in absence of oxygen, which produces alcohol. How alcohol produces is yeast converts. Okay, there is a yeast, so yeast converts sugar to alcohol by fermentation. Okay, so basically it is used to produce wine, beer, etc. So in many industries it is used, fermentation, basically in curing process where the use of Bacillus megatherium is used. Okay, Bacillus megatherium is used in curing where the green leaves or the coffee beans are okay, they are the moist ones, so they remove the moist, ferment those things, those green leaves, with the help of Bacillus megatherium, removing the moisture from the leaves and inhibits different bacteria or fungus, okay, attack. So it will not spoil those leaves and all, and it will also add flavor to the tea or coffee. Another is the production of vinegar, use of bacterial aceto. In this case, coffee or tea curing, Bacillus megatherium is used. In case of vinegar production, acetobacter ACT is used. Production of alcohol, Clostridium acetobutylum butylicum is used. And in case of production of some acids, Aspergillus niger is used. Now see DNA and genetic engineering. This is completely a different new topic for everyone now. This is already, so we should know about what is genetic engineering and how DNA, how they are applying DNA, they are manipulating DNA, our genetic body. Okay, so it's one of the most advanced research field in science. So DNA is, you know, all DNA, what is DNA? No, so DNA is genetic material which carries information of our body in the form of genes, and which carries and which transfers from generation to generation, isn't it? So this is DNA. So scientists have developed techniques, so they help, okay, the techniques, genes, they also use a gene, so they use a genes to cure various diseases with the help of genetic engineering. So there are many genetic rare genetic diseases, so they manipulate those genes to cure those diseases. Genetic engineering also called, now see here, the direct manipulation of an organism genes using biotechnology. So genetic manipulation is done, so in which, okay, in this genetic manipulation, viruses plays very important role due to the ability to remove genes. Why? Okay, in this genetic manipulation, why viruses are used? Because viruses move genetic information from one cell to another due to their ability to move genetic information from one cell to another. Okay, they are useful in making copies of DNA. This helps delivering gene therapy or gene transformation. So transferring a genetic information from one cell to another, it is a gene therapy or gene transformation. So viruses are basically used. Okay, because why viruses are used? There are two reasons the viruses are used: because of the simplicity of structure and ability to multiply rapidly. This is the basic thing what happens, the basic thing what they do in genetic engineering. Next is genetic, you can see here, so researchers isolate gene from an organism that is straight they want. Okay, what happens in this case is genetic engineering, we can isolate a particular gene and we can impart into the cell. So later we want isolating a gene and creating a kind of plant or animal that we want, the trait with character we want. So if you want a plant to have plant that gives more fruit, okay, so what we do is basically is, or the plant which gives more fruit, okay, so what we do is we will isolate a single gene which gives, okay, we will if you go around and you see a tree that gives more fruit than another, you can compare it or like that. So you can compare it, and when you see that there are some species or there are some trees or plants are there that gives more fruits than as compared to others, then what you can do is you can isolate the gene from that plant or that tree, fruit tree, okay. So you can isolate the gene, and what you can do is you can isolate the gene in a separate, okay. And next thing what you do, you can copy that gene, okay, you can keep it into a growth medium, and you can copies, you can make more copies of the gene, okay, you can make more copies of gene. And what you do, then you can insert into a plant cells, okay, into a plant cells. You can again take out plant cells. We need a plant cells to grow a new plant, so you can take out this cells from these plants, okay. Again, together what you do is you can insert those genes into these cells. So what happens here, those, it will get multiply those, okay, the tissues, plant tissues with the new, the isolated gene trait, okay, isolated gene, it will get multiplied here. And what happens that you will keep it in, and you will keep it those thing in this growth medium. Growth medium means it is a medium where all the different minerals, vitamins and import essential things, whatever they whatever a cell require to grow, it is put into a growth medium, okay. So it is a medium, it becomes a complete atmosphere where a cell can grow. So you can put this into this growth medium and let multiply that isolated gene with the plant tissues. So later what happens, you keep it for that seed, okay, that plant cells into a transforming into a plant. So seeds from mature plants, okay, as studied of. Now what happens is, now these cells become the plant, and this plant will be completely a plant with a new trait. So now, as we have in example, we have said that we want a plant with more plant which gives more fruits as compared to other trees. No, so now we have these genes that we have selected that with more, that gives more fruits. Now these with plant cells, now these are multiplied and we let them to grow into a plant. Now this plant have the trait of giving more fruits as compared to others. So this is what we can do in genetic engineering. These are the examples, okay, these are the fruit damage. You can see these are the non-BT plant. These are the normal eggplant or the brinjal fruits or brinjal, okay, these are vegetables. So these are the normal vegetables which are, you can see which are rotten or which are being attacked by the worms and the pest. In this case, BT plants, you can see it is not attacked or it is, not rotten, it is in good condition. You can see these are the maize, okay, corn. And this, corn and this cotton, these are the two most genetically modified crops, okay, most produced in this world. So what happened in this case, later I will talk it to, okay, the examples, how, what is BT plant and non-BT plant. This is same, the corn are the BT corn or non-BT corn, this cotton are the BT cotton or non-BT cotton. So what happens, discuss in the next slide. So this is, you can see the clone shock, you know, sheep Dolly, the first mammal copied from there. Okay, this is what we have done, is the same genetic engineering, genetic process has been applied in this case. Okay, from a single cell taken from a body, now it has been put into the that growth medium to grow, and that cell was later inserted into a shape. So that the sheep was born with the help of genetic engineering. Okay, first this is the clone sheep. The gene has been copied and later put into the again sheep, and has been later it give that sheep gives birth to this sheep Dolly. It is the first mammal copied from adult animal. So these are the copied, from the copied genes another animal has been developed. So cloning is another thing. Now these are the cloning. Okay, the parent cell has been cloned to another, that's offspring. Now this is another cloning, example of cloning in India. So female calf Swarupa born with the help of new hand guided cloning technique by using donor cell from ear. Now this is developed, used, this baby cell is formed using donor cell from ear of an adult buffalo. Okay, so this helps in white revolution, that is production of milk. So this buffalo produces more milk. So that particular character trait has been induced in this buffalo. Now next is nitrogen fixation. So what is nitrogen fixation? It is a natural process of absorption of nitrogen, atmospheric nitrogen, by plants. Okay, so there are 78% of nitrogen, 78% of nitrogen gas in atmosphere, which are non-reactive in nature, but it cannot be absorbed directly by the plants. So it takes a process or a way of called a nitrogen cycle or nitrogen fixation cycle is there. Okay, how the plant absorbs those free nitrogens. So nitrogen is some of the most essential, these are the most essential constituent of all living organisms. Okay, which is a part of protein, chlorophyll, nucleic acids and vitamins. Now the atmospheric nitrogen, it cannot be taken directly. I said that nitrogen, it cannot be taken directly by plants or animals. So it takes different pathway with the help of bacteria, certain bacteria or microorganisms, blue-green algae, to fix it in the soil, and later that fixed nitrogen is absorbed by plants. Okay, with the help of roots. Now see, the most commonly absorbed form of nitrogen is nitrate and ammonium. These two are the most commonly absorbed form of nitrogen. Once nitrogen is converted in this unusable compounds, it can be utilized. Okay, and animals, later the animals feed on these plants to get proteins and nitrogen compound. So when plants and animals dies, okay, so once the plant absorbs those free nitrogen with the help of, okay, after being fixed by different microorganisms and algae in the soil, and later absorbed by the plant roots, okay, it is been, then it will use those nitrogen by plants to produce proteins and all foods. Okay, so what happens later when those plants or animals which took, okay, and later being again taken by the animal eat, feeds upon those plants, or the animal those feeds upon plants. So it's kind of cycle chain. So what happens, so again, when those plants and animals dies, okay, some bacteria and fungi work on that, start walking upon the body of those dead animal or the plants, okay, and they break down the proteins in their bodies, okay, to form ammonia and the nitrate compounds. Again, those nitrogen after taking nitrogen, they make proteins and all in the body. So once the plants and animals die, what happens? Some kind of bacteria and fungi starts walking in that body, breaking down the proteins in their bodies to form ammonia and nitrogen compounds. Bacteria convert some of those compounds nitrogen into really okay. So now what happens? Some bacteria convert those compounds in nitrogen gas and later released into the atmosphere. So as a result, the percentage of nitrogen in atmosphere remains more or less constant. So more or less it is constant. So animals absorb it, process it, and later when it dies, it will release it into the nature only. Or atmosphere. So examples of the algae and bacteria, cyanobacteria or blue green algae, you can see here, Anabaena, Nostoc, and Cyanobacteria, and Isobium is there, found mostly in root nodules. So we will discuss about this. What is Rhizobium? So you can see role of bacteria Rhizobium. Rhizobium bacteria, okay. Now please don't forget this. Rhizobium bacteria lives in and infect roots of leguminous plants like beans or lobster noodles. Leguminous plants means those plants which gives fruit, that seed pod, okay, that is like beans, pea, lenticels, etc. Basically lenticels, pea, beans, etc. In this plant, these plants are called leguminous plants, okay. So they form a lump or nodules in their roots. If these are the roots, okay, so you can find lump like this. Just like this, this root in the root, okay. These nodules, lump, or you will get to see nodules in these roots. So the bacteria releases, okay, the bacteria releases enzymes that supply constant source of reduced nitrogen to plants. So this bacteria helps. Okay, bacteria can possess enzymes within this lump. They possess enzymes, okay, that supply constant source of reduced nitrogen to plants. In return, plant produces nutrients for the bacterium. In this way, the plant and they both have the symbiotic relationship. Okay, so plants. This bacteria helps to supply nitrogen, reduce nitrogen to the plant. Reduce nitrogen means the most simplest form of nitrogen, that is ammonium or the nitrate to the plant. Okay, and in return, what the plant gives is the plant produces nutrients for the bacteria. So these are the kind of symbiotic relationship. So this is the role of Rhizobium bacteria. So biological control, that even microorganisms are used in biological control, okay, they are used as biological pesticides. Pesticide means, okay, actually basically in plants, normally what we do is we spray different pesticides, different medicines to kill the different bacteria or pest or different insects, okay, inhibiting them from destroying the our crops or the plants, okay. So what we do is basically we spray chemicals, but in case sometimes we can use these microorganisms or bacteria in biological control using as known as biological pesticides. Those are the chemical pesticides, okay, when we spray chemical things, but these are the biological pesticides which don't harm other organisms or other plants, okay. In case of those chemical, they will definitely harm along with the bacteria. They kill bacteria, but sometimes what happens, the residues remain in the soil, so later which mix, okay, which get mixed in a soil or fruit that we eat, and that makes us sick, and that is very harmful to us. But in case of biological pesticides, it is not. So in studies, the characteristics of some microorganisms and the role in pest control of biological pesticides. Example, bacteria used to kill insect. Okay, a bacteria called, okay, basically a bacteria called Beta Bacillus thuringiensis is introduced into an insect species such as caterpillar. Okay, the bacteria is introduced into insect, which means the chemical gene. Okay, the gene from Bacillus thuringiensis, it is very toxic to the caterpillars. It is introduced into the insect species through plants. So we'll study later. Okay, now there is another term called social biology. So it's the study of how humans, plants and animals, okay, how humans, plants and animals coexist together and affect each other. So now this is the BT gene inserted into crop. Okay, so Bacillus thuringiensis is this. Okay, from here a gene, its BT gene is isolated. Okay, this gene is isolated, and which is very poisonous or harmful for this. These are very harmful to this. So what happens when we isolate this gene that is very toxic to this thing? We will insert it into a plant cell. Okay, either the corn cell or a cotton cell or anything. So we will put this into the plant cell. We will put it into a medium. We keep it medium. We will let them grow. We'll let them multiply. We'll let them grow into a plant. And this plant now contains fully this BT gene. Okay. So now what happens is this BT gene plants. Okay. When this worm, ball worm, or this pest, okay, this caterpillar attacks this plant, comes to feeds upon, what happens is now the crop is already, this gene is inserted. So now when it takes it when it feeds upon this thing, what happens now? What happens? This, once they take in the, once this plant is in, passes it through the stomach, okay, this toxin has with the BT gene, okay, with inserted into plant, it gets released into the stomach. Okay, stomach, and which is very toxic, and starts, and it becomes poisonous to them, and later it dies. There is another example you can see here. Okay, this plant is, what happened, the BT, okay, BT cells, or the BT cell has been inserted into this plant, okay, through the cell medium, it, okay, isolating a gene, and later from the plant, it inserted a plant cell, let them multiply, and after multiplying, let them grow, and it becomes a plant, and now it gives fruit. Now once the crystal occur, once this larvae, or what we can say is, once this worm, okay, attacks the plant, what happens is the crystal and spore ingested by the crystals and spores are ingested by insect larva, toxins are active formed by gut. Okay, this toxin activated in the gut by gut enzyme. So now what happens, toxin binds on this very, okay, so activated toxins binds to receptor, subsequently inserted into the membrane, causing leakage of ions. And okay, so now meat cut membrane damages to lead starvation or septicemia. So septicemia, or the, it makes leakage of ions, or okay, damages the cell or the meat cut membrane of the this worm, and it leads to starvation and septicemia. And this is how this worm dies, and the crop gets saved. And this will not harm other plants. Okay, this will not even harm, this poison will not even harm humans. This is for this particular insect. So this is how genetic engineering or genetic manipulation is done, and these are being used, okay, for the benefit of human beings. And you can see this is the last, the nitrogen cycle where, okay, there is atmospheric nitrogen. Okay, this atmospheric nitrogen here outside, and it should be absorbed by the plants, okay, for the production of proteins and all, and essential vitamins or minerals in the plants, and later it should be it will be taken by the plants. But now what happens, it cannot be directly, okay, it cannot be directly eaten by animal, or it cannot be directly uptaken by plants. So what happens, it will either, what happens, lightning happens in atmosphere, either with the help of lightning the nitrogen gets fixed, okay, lightning fixes the nitrogen and compounds the nitrogen in the soil, okay, and it gets mixed in the mixed with the nitrogen soil, okay. And although this is the first way, either the lightning happens and it fixes the nitrogen, and number two is nitrogen fixing bacteria and blue-green algae fix atmospheric nitrogen, and bacteria in turn fix nitrogen into nitrogenous compound, and it will again move to this soil. So this is the main center. So either this will come to this will come to this, and this will come to this, and compound the nitrogen in the soil. So what happens after coming to soil, what happens, bacteria turn compounds in nitrogen into gaseous nitrogen, okay. Let's see, basically this, and this compound of nitrogen, okay, this uptake by plants. Now this nitrogen compound, that is either nitrate or ammonium, is taken by the plant, okay, and these plants are being taken by animals eat plants, and later either both animals and plants will die, okay, or the nitrogenous waste from animals excreta are later, what happens, they get into the soil, and animals or different bacteria acts upon and will again get into the soil. So once it gets in the soil, now bacteria turns nitrogen gases, okay, nitrogenous into gaseous nitrogen, and it is again goes back to the nitrogen. So more or less, the nitrogen that is being absorbed by the plants later go back to the atmosphere only. So there is kind of equal proportion. So this is nitrogen cycle. So in this topic we have covered antibiotic, vaccines, fermentation, genetic engineering or gene manipulation, examples of different BT crops, cloning of animals, dolly sheep and a buffalo in India, nitrogen fixation, BT crops, okay, use of genetic manipulation, how the genes are being transferred from one cell to another, or one organism to another. So this topic covers these various things. So I think this video being helpful to you, so let me know. And for any queries, let me know. Thank you.